There is one powerful thing that you have full control over that can absolutely change the way that you feel about yourself and what you believe about yourself in order to achieve the life and the career and whatever are your dreams and your goals that you have in the back burner. So in this video, I'm going to be discussing how changing your habits is the key to changing your life. Escape the 9-to-5 and create your path to freedom. Hey, thanks for joining me for another episode of Screw the Cubicle TV. I'm Lydia Lee, the life strategist and work reinvention coach at Screw the Cubicle. And this channel is really dedicated to help you through transitions in your life and through the reinventions that you're about to embark into discovering and creating your next big thing. So today's video is really dedicated to answer this question. How is changing my habits going to change the things that I believe about myself? Now, I know at the crossroad of doing something bigger with our lives, maybe you're in the midst of launching a business or maybe figuring out what to do with your life in your next path of life, or you have been dreaming of doing a creative project and something inside of you keeps sort of keeping you stuck, believing that you're not capable, right? Or you're not ready enough to go after the things that you want to pursue. Now, I know that change is scary. Reinvention is scary. Doing anything brand new in our lives that's not on the autopilot default of patterns that we have behaved in our lives is going to feel like a struggle. But I also want you to know that every minute of the day, every hour of the day, you have an opportunity to turn it all around. And it doesn't have to be this big grand gesture or a big grand move of what you think it takes for you to step into the new starring role that you want to play in your life. So habits are huge in how we want to actually reimagine who we need to become in order to have the things in the life that we want to have. Now, this is something that I certainly didn't take into too much account when I have been transitioning in the past, or especially years ago, right, going from employee to entrepreneur. A lot of what I focused my energy and time doing was learning new things and sort of reading more and researching more and just like piling up stuff on my plate to do in order to think that I'm ready enough, right, to pursue entrepreneurship or whatever the life changes I was dealing with at the time. But habits are one of the things that you can fully control every day in the smallest way possible that can lead to incrementally to amazing results. Now, let me tell you why habits have something to do with your self-identity. First of all, your self-identity is really formulated by the backgrounds of experiences that whether it's people around you have told you, this is what you're good at, this is what you're doing, here's where you stand in life, and you've believed them, right? In some way, you've accepted some of them still hold true to you, and that is the identity that forms what it is, that who you are today, right? It formulates also the decisions that you will make in your life based on this identity. And sometimes, as we go through transition to something new, it's because there's been a nagging feeling inside of us that what we're doing, what we're spending our time and energy doing right now isn't where I want to go anymore. And that's okay. So first of all, don't feel guilty that you've changed your mind on your course of your life path, because this is going to happen over and over again. And it's totally fine. It's not like you're having, you know, being a fraud or that none of your values mattered to you before. It just means that you're really stepping into being evolving, right, into a different person, evolving to be a better person of who you will need to become to live a fully, highly purposeful life. So when you think about what has formulated your identity, it's very likely a lot of things that you've done over and over again on repeat, right? Sort of like a broken record in a lot of ways of this is who I am, is how I introduce myself at dinner parties. Here is what people know me for. Here's what people rely on me for. And maybe some of those ideas and notions that used to be your identity may no longer be where you want to sort of be designing your life towards, right? That's why you're here, probably listening to this video. So it's also fair to say that if habits and all the repetitive behaviors that you have been doing in your life has formulated your today's identity, right? It's also fair to say that new habits can formulate a new identity. And, you know, a lot of people always ask me the question of, how do I get braver? How do I just like become like you maybe and start to just take a leap at something and just trust that things will work out? But the truth is that that never happens to me. And I don't think that really happens to a lot of people that you might see and perceive that they're just super brave and courageous and they could just go after things and it just miraculously happens for them. Very likely the truth is that these people have nurtured good habits and used those habits to then become the person they need to be to do the things that they need to do for their lives and want to do for their lives. So that could be very true for you too. Little habits every single day when it comes to the habit of your mind, the habit of your thoughts, what you decide to put your energy and focus on that's either leading you to a life experience you want to have or it isn't. Those little micro decisions and things that you say yes or no to every single day is actually almost putting a vote for you, right? Or you put all those actions equals some votes in a particular jar of a life that you know, want to have or you don't. So that's something that I want you to just feel a bit present and grounded to, is that everything that you start to think of, that you read, that you choose to discuss and converse on every day is the thing that is putting that computer program, right, on a particular way that is formulating ideas for you to take for the future. So you want to be very mindful about what it is that you surround yourself with, but what it is that you are focusing your energy doing every single day. So if you've ever read a very famous book called Atomic Habits by James Clear, James says, to change your behavior for good, you need to start believing new things about yourself and you need to build an identity-based habit. So habits will help you to, as you do them repeatedly, because again, right, as we take on new activities, we are really training our brains, which is kind of a bit of a monkey mind, to create, right, new neural pathways, that is. And the pathways will get stronger with repetition, as we talked about, until that behavior becomes the new normal. And so very small changes done often enough can make a huge difference. As I said, no big leaps are necessary. It's small incremental leaps that make the difference. Here are some examples. So let's say you want to be a writer. You dream to have a book. You dream to be an author. You dream to make money as a writer in the future. And you're not quite sure, well, how do I get started writing a book right now? Oh God, I don't even have ideas for a book. Am I good enough to write a book? Do I need to take a course on a book? Right? None of those are helpful perspectives because it kind of feels like that thing feels a bit too far from you. But what is a smaller, more reachable habit that you can actually cultivate in your daily life right now that can lead you to the bigger goal of being an author? And that could be just writing 500 to 1,000 words every day without even people seeing it if you don't want it to be that way. You could start a secret blog, right? Or write on Medium where you just choose to strengthen your muscle as a writer, to find your voice, to figure out what it is that you really want to say that could potentially in the future accumulate to some big ideas that can actually change the world. You don't need to be able to have a great big idea for a book. You just need to start writing. So cultivating the habit of writing means that you are taking time to look at your calendar, setting up a block of time, maybe even it's an hour every other day, or 30 minutes every other day, or 15 minutes every other day. As you start to do that, you will move from the identity of I want to be a writer to I am a writer, because you are doing the activities that is in alignment with a bigger goal and a dream that you seek out for yourself. Or let's say you want to be a leadership expert, right? That wants to start, and you're someone that wants to start a business around that passion. Don't wait until, you know, the best business model comes to your brain, or when you start a website, or when you start to get clients. Start leading in the community that you belong to. Start going out there and figuring out, how can I lead in my community right now in a problem that I can help solve? How can I step into my own leadership role before I start to coach other people on leadership? I need to feel like I'm a leader. I need to appear like a leader in my own life and in the lives of other people before I can sort of step into the role that I'm a leadership expert. Maybe you're in a workplace right now and there's an opportunity there to step up in your leadership skills and your role there without it being a business right away. So as you can see, you have full control over who you want to become. You know, instead of just a mantra that you repeat in the mirror every day, I am this person, I am that person, prove it to yourself by doing some small actions that can honor, right? What it is that you want to believe in yourself and prove it by doing some real action that can lead you to this bigger role that you want to take in the future. Okay, so I want to hear from you. What is a small habit that you can implement in your life today and something that's reachable? Again, nothing too big of a leap, a small leap. What can you do in a small action consistently every single day or every single week to step into the new role that you want to play as a person in your life or in a particular focus of interest of work that you would hope to start in the future? So comment below, let me know what that is so that we can hold each other accountable and I can check in with you, hopefully in the next week or two, that you are actually doing it and stepping into this role and seeing how you feel when you give yourself permission to become this person today, instead of waiting for the perfect time if you're ready enough or you're expert enough to do so. I hope that video resonates with you. It certainly was something that I needed to learn a lot to feel brave and courageous to do things. And I do so many things that are so beyond my comfort zone every single year in my business and in my life. And I too have to adapt to these practices of just small little habits to increase my courage to do big things in my life, but also to let myself put on a little, you know, put on that new role for size, to really see how I feel when I step into that role without the expectations of it to be, I don't know, a money-making project or whatever it is that I think validates me as that real person in that role. So if you enjoyed this video, and if you haven't subscribed, please do by clicking the notification button or the subscribe button, and feel free to share it with your friends, anyone that you know that's going to kind of stuck a little bit on believing that they can be the person they need to be, right? Or they need to become to have the life they want. This video might be helpful for them to get started in. Thank you so much for joining me today and for taking the time to spend some time with me. And as always, your feedback is always appreciated. So if this video instigated new ideas for any new videos that I could film for you, I'm your gal. I would love to incorporate some of your ideas on this channel, and of course, to start any discussions that could spark inspiration within you right now. Thanks for joining me.